Animal trainer Mark Katz is here to answer your pet questions. How are you today?
Great. I think they should have Charles in the show.
I think so.
I think somebody should call him right away. Look at that.
Tell us about Charles.
He belongs in the show. He's up for adoption. Or TV and movie work.
He's so cute.
At the Maryland SPCA on Falls Road, he's 5 years old. I think he's a Chihuahua. They want to argue with me about him having miniature pincher in him. And who knows? Nobody has records on him other than he's wonderful.
He hasn't made a sound.
He's absolutely perfect. He could be good in the show.
Yeah, he'd be adorable.
He could have his own part. I think he'd be great. But he's up for adoption at Maryland SPCA on Falls Road today. Mm-hmm. 410-235-8826.
Okay.
Is the phone number there.
Mark, you and I were talking about something called a thunder jacket.
Tell us more about that. Something brand new. My wife's a veterinarian. I read about it in one of her journals, and it's a jacket. It's like a vest that goes over the dog. They can wear it during thunderstorms, and they don't know exactly, technically, scientifically, why it works, but in 50% of the dogs studied, it kept the dogs calm and relaxed, and they don't know if it's just like giving the dog a hug or exactly why, but it works.
So it gives them some type of comfort.
And it's non-invasive. It's not medication, so I think it's worth trying or looking into.
Is that easy to find?
I would call pet shops for pet's sake on Falls Road. Simi is trying to order some. She may have some in, and that's where to start. And then maybe you can network from there.
All right, we'll get to some questions,
Mark. Sure.
I have a one-year-old Japanese Shih Tzu. Thank you.
Yes.
It's been a while. All right. He's a quick learner and for the most part well-behaved, but he has a horrible attitude. He growls at other dogs at the vet's office, and sometimes he's so stubborn he refuses to listen. How can I fix this?
He's not trained, which is very common. And small dogs can learn as much as larger dogs, just that people feel because they're small, they don't really have to until a problem develops, and then it's a little more serious. You have to get into a training class. First of all, I like to eliminate any medical component because sometimes if you're not feeling well, you can be cranky and irritable.
Right.
So you want to eliminate that. Get with a trainer who has experience with small dogs because it's different. It's still a dog, but it's a different size. You have to know the characteristics of the breeds. And some of the breeds can be nervous and anxious. And a lot of people just don't socialize them correctly. And you were commenting earlier, why do small dogs shake? Now, he's being extremely good, actually, for a small dog. Mm. But they don't socialize them. They don't get them out in the community.
So that's the key.
They don't get them with other people or other dogs. So that's a really big component. But get into a training class. Talk to a behaviorist after you speak to your vet about the medical components that could be affecting the behavior.
Sounds good, Mark.
Sure.
We have an 8-year-old female house cat. She's active and free of fleas and mites. Her skin scraping showed nothing, but she continues to chew on one of her front legs and has a big bald spot. Any suggestions?
That's not uncommon. They call them lick granulomas in dogs, and I'm not sure I think so with cats. But if you've checked with your veterinarian and there are no medical issues and components to the problem, they get bored. And sometimes they need, scratching posts and more toys or catnip or more social interaction, maybe with another cat or with their human.
Excellent advice. Thanks
sure.
so much. Nice seeing you, Mark, as always.
To see you.
Appreciate
Thank you for having
it.
Us. Charles.
A home for Charles. Very
Thank
sweet
you.
Dog.